High School Athletic Association proudly presents another championship event.
A starting field of some 395 teams paired up 5 weeks ago. We are down to the final two. And those two clubs are here at Market Square Arena in Indianapolis tonight to battle for the 74th championship in the IHSAA Boys State Basketball Tournament. On the court and ready to go for that coveted title, the Alices of Vincennes, two-time state champions, now 24-3 on the year, and the Warsaw Tigers with a record of 25-2 and seeking their first ever state basketball crown. Happy you could join us. Hello, everybody. I'm Jerry Baker. Along with Hilliard, Gates, and Joe Sexton, we are live in front of a jam-packed crowd at Market Square Arena this Saturday night, set for the state championship basketball game. How did they get here? Well, the Vincennes Odysseys did it with a 64-56 win over Lake Central. All five of their starters in double figures, led by their outstanding guard, Dean Tolbert, with 15. Warsaw, 78-74 over Newcastle, Marty Lehman with 23. How do they stack up comparatively? Statistically, here's the way it looks. Vincennes 24-3, Warsaw 25-2. The Tigers of Warsaw, the top offensive team, Vincennes leads in defense. Field goal percentages, that belongs to Warsaw. Free throw, that goes to Vincennes. And the Alices have a distinct disadvantage in the rebound department. They're being out-rebounded by a dozen as far as Warsaw is concerned. So that's the way they look, at least on paper today. That doesn't count. What's going to count is what happens in the next couple of hours here at Market Square Arena. So stand by. Back for the opening tip-off in just a moment. One of your network sponsors is Farm Bureau Insurance. Set for the pregame ceremonies prior to tonight's telecast of this state championship game, Vincennes and Warsaw. Tom Carnegie is across the floor. Let's go over to Tom again.
Presenting the pregame ceremonies are members of the Auxiliary Corps of the Western High School Marching Band from Rocheville. Directors are Karen Whitford and band director Larry Neuhauser. For the past 2 years, this Western Marching Band has been the state champions in their class, and the drill team and flag corps were named Best Auxiliary this year at the Marching Bands of America Grand National Championship. Tonight's show was designed by Alice Tembe, and cheerleaders from the Indiana School for the Deaf will do the Star Spangled Banner in sign language. Marcy Kovach is the sponsor.
We're just seconds away from the introduction of the starting lineups for tonight's championship game between Vincennes and Warsaw. One of your network sponsors is American Fletcher National Bank. One of the key players of that Vincennes victory today was number 10, Dean Tolbert, a 5'9 senior. Those are his numbers on the screen. His average on the year was 13.5 points. He shot 60% from the floor on the year, which is what he had today, 77% from the free throw line. For the Warsaw Tigers, they are led by number 45, Marty Lehman, a 6'7 senior. It was a well-balanced scoring attack for Warsaw today, but Marty was the key player as far as scoring was concerned. He had a total of 23 in the win this afternoon over Newcastle, 78-74. Marty Lehman, averaging 19.5 points per game, had 23 today, hitting 61% from the floor on the year, 64 on the season. And although he had 8 rebounds today, his average on the year is 11.5 per ball game. Just two of the key players that we'll be watching in this championship game tonight. Buzzer is sounded. Both ball clubs heading back to their respective benches and their coaches, Dean Miller of Vincennes, Al Rhodes of Warsaw. Let's go back again now for the introduction of the starting lineups.
Presenting the starting lineup of the two teams vying for the state championship. First, the Tigers of Warsaw. Number 13, Scott Long. Number 25, Steve Hollar. Number 33, Bob Randell. Number 43, Jeff Gross. Number Number 45, Marty Lehman. And the coach of the Warsaw Tigers, Alan Rose. And here is the starting combination for the Vincennes Lincoln Hollar. At one guard, number 10, Dean Tolbert. At the other guard, number 44, Randy Hobson. At forward, number 30, Tim Swan. Number 52, Charles Waggoner. The center, number 54, Paul Hendrickson. And the coach, Gene Miller.
And the tension begins to mount. Vincennes, Warsaw, state championship. Tip-off 1 minute from now. We'll return. One of your network sponsors is Farm Bureau Insurance. Here are the matchups. Warsaw's guards averaging 35-8. Vincennes 23.5. At forward, 24 per game for Warsaw, 23 per game for Vincennes.
And the officials on the right, Roger DeYoung from Hebron, Indiana, and Melvin Redmond of Mount Vernon. Redmond in his first championship, and Roger DeYoung in his fifth.
Couple of good ones. Jerry Baker, Joe Sexton, Hilliard Gates, ready to go now. Boy, nobody saw their ticket, did they, guys? Or they're still here. Capacity crowd in excess of 17,000 as Warsaw and Vincennes go for the title. The tip controlled by Warsaw. They'll wear the dark uniforms. They're 25-2. They win over Newcastle today, 78-74. Vincennes gets here with the victory over Lake Sutcliffe. And Warsaw jumps in front in a hurry in this ballgame with the outside shooting of Steve Hollar.
Start right out with a 2-2-1 full court press by Warsaw.
Well, Steve Hollar, by the way, that's the first basket of the day. He did not score from the field in the afternoon game. 30 seconds gone, 2-0 ball game. Warsaw with the lead. Rebounded by Vincennes. Good block that time on number 45, Marty Lehman. Joe, I really don't think that we're going to have to talk a lot about the fatigue factor as we have in years gone by, because I think both clubs had plenty of time to get rest today.
Yeah, that's a pretty tough ball game. We'll just have to keep an eye on the players on that one, Jerry.
Well, I agree they were tough. I just don't think they were maybe as quite as tough as we've had in the past as far as having to come back and play in a 3 or 4 hour span of time.
The only thing I was thinking about was the game that went until the last 48 seconds of the first quarter. They really went hard the first quarter.
I think it's been a 20-point game that has still been going hard the last few seconds, though. Vincennes got the bucket from Hendrickson. Now they come back at the other end, and a foul is called to see if the basket is going to count by Steve Hollar. It will.
It's going to count, right. Steve Hollar gets his second hoop right here on a nice drive. And you can see right there's the foul. He had the opening and took it. And he's taking charge here. As you said, he didn't have a basket in the first game this afternoon, and now he has two already, a chance to get his first 5 points for his ball club.
He is a 6'1 junior with an average of 4.2 per game, and he is now over his average. In the first minute and 5 seconds of the state championship game, he was perfect from the free throw line today. 4 out of 4, those were his only points. Knocked away, belongs to Vincennes. Hilliard?
Jerry, Scott Long had his career high 10 points this afternoon for Warsaw.
Interesting, he would wait till the state championship to pull off that little escapade. Analysis of old Vincennes. Green and white, school colors. There's the outside shooting of Dean Tolbert. Well, this young man showed only he had 15 points. He must have been worth 30 that game today. Here is the steal. Basket will count, and a foul is called. First of the game against Warsaw. It is on Rob Randles. Number one on him. And Vincennes will go to the line in the form of that young man, Tim Swan.
All right, here's the steal here by Swan. They're full court pressure again, man pressure. There's the foul right there. He powers it up. same thing they did this afternoon. Got a steal early with their full court man-to-man pressure.
Yeah, in the semi-state, Swan had 15 points, 12 against Northeast DuBois, three more against Floyd Central. He was an all Big 8 conference player this year. Can't get the free throw to fall. And it's a 6-5 basketball game. Vincennes out in front by one. First time they have led. Well, they love to run a break, don't they? This is Tolbert. And rebounded in the middle by Warsaw. They had an outlet man. Couldn't get the ball up court to him. The outlet man was Hollar. Let the traffic clear and set up the offense again. What kind of defense is Vincennes using, Joe Sexton?
Vincennes is using a man-to-man defense. It looked like they might be doing something just a little out of the ordinary. The way they're getting around the baseline, it looks like they're going to drop down like they did this afternoon and get in front and in back of the big guy. And, of course, tonight it's Lehman, Marty Lehman.
Tim Swan made the steal. Vincennes basketball. Here is Tolbert down to the baseline of Waggoner, missing badly on that baseline area. And the rebound comes off of the air ball. Actually, comes off to Warsaw. It's Gross, who was hot this afternoon, missing his first attempt tonight. Rebound Randles. Now rebounded by Vincennes, Tim Swan. 5.5 minutes to play. First quarter, 6-5 is the score. Vincennes out in front. And the Vincennes cheering section just explodes, and the Randleses get to that end of the court. Hobson couldn't get the roll, and it's out of bounds, and last touch by Vincennes. Paul Hendrickson knocked it off his knee. So Warsaw will inbounds. Warsaw Community High School. Up north, Hillier, that's up in your country up there. Up around Fort Wayne, isn't it?
42 miles northwest.
Vincennes, of course, south of here. Southern third of the state. An historic city.
Another steal.
Steal is made by Swan. In for the layup.
There's that quickness you alluded to, Hillard.
Well, they're also dropping Dean Tolbert in front of Marty Lehman. They're putting a man in front of him and a man behind him. They're really playing two men on Marty Lehman.
Right.
Biggest lead for either ball club at 3 points. Vincennes in front, 8-5. 4.5 minutes to play in the first quarter. A lot of green on that side of the arena because that's where Newcastle sat earlier today. Here's a foul. Swan, with great position, goes up for the rebound. And the foul is against Warsaw. And it looks like Scott Long may be hit with a personal foul. He does. And that is number one on him.
Here's Tim Swan now. He's all the way over. Now, there's a good shot of him getting pushed there by Scott Long. Tim Swan, it appears, Hilliard, is playing in the lane.
Right.
And whichever side the wing they go to and try to dump it into the low post, then Swan takes the backside of the defense.
Great defensive play by Jeff Gross for Warsaw. Hey, both these ball clubs have got some quickness. You don't want to lollygag any passes anywhere because he'll be over to get it. Well, I don't know where he is. Hollar must have been saving his shot for the championship game, Joe. He was 0 for 3 this afternoon.
What it is, Jerry, is the fact that Tim Swan is supposed to be guarding him. He's matched up with him, but he is making him make some baskets here. We'll probably see Tim get up a little tighter on him now that he's made three hoops.
Cuts the lead to one now, 8-7. Also rebounding, isn't it?
That's a tough shot.
Here's Hollar again. Out to Randles. Looking inside. They've got it in there to Gross. Blocked beautifully that time by Tim Swan, who's everywhere.
Look at this speed.
Tolbert takes it down the lane. The 15-footer won't go. The rebound pulled off by Vincennes. Still won't fall. This time for Waggoner. And Warsaw brings it back again with 3:05 to play in the first quarter. Non-stop action live from Market Square Arena, downtown Indianapolis. Lehman short. Rebound picked off by Vincennes. Warsaw not getting very many second opportunities. Dean Tolbert, a 5'9 senior starting guard. Hendrickson on the miss, and the rebound comes to Warsaw again.
Marty Lehman got switched off on Dean Tolbert that time.
Vincennes has been ahead by three. Warsaw has led by two. Now the Owls is up by one, 8-7. Oh, they got a wide open man on the other side of the cut. And the bucket belongs to 43, Jeff Gross, his first of the night.
Well, he does marvelously without the ball. He rolled off the play away from the wall.
Well, he had a great game today, Hilliard. He had 10 of 18 from the floor, 2 out of 2 from the line, a total of 22 points. His average is 21-7, so he's right on the numbers there. 2:15 to play, and they turn the ball over. No 5-second call.
Right.
And I'll tell you who helped him make that call was the Warsaw coach, Al Rhodes. There he is on your screen. He was calling out the violation. Timeout has been called. 9-8 is your score. Warsaw leads Vincennes. 2:13 to go first quarter. We'll take a timeout also. One of your network sponsors, Farm Bureau Insurance. 15-7 last year, losing to Evansville Bossy in the regional afternoon game. Out of bounds, last touch by Warsaw. It'll belong to Vincennes. Turning it around, Vincennes 16-7, losing to Evansville Bossy in the regional afternoon game. Warsaw last year was 14-10. They lost to Plymouth in the Elkhart regional championship game. But one of the reasons they may be here, Hilliard and Joe, they had a JV team last year, 13-7, and a freshman team that was 17-3.
The officials couldn't agree, so they have a jump ball, Jerry.
I will jump it at the free throw line of the Warsaw Tigers. Tap control by Warsaw. Rob Randall's with it. Set up the offensive long range. Randall's gets the hoop. First of the game for Rob, who had 8 out of 13 from the floor and finished up with 19 points in the afternoon game. It's 11-8 now. Warsaw's got the lead, and that's the first time they've had that sizable margin. Roll on the other end goes to Tim Swan for his third bucket and 6 points. A minute and a half to go. First quarter. 11-10, Warsaw. Tigers have the lead and the basketball.
Shot!
Saved beautifully so by Marty Lehman. Here is Hollar again. Off his running mate, Gross. Or long, and picked up now by Gross. 1 minute to play in the quarter, 11-10, Warsaw. Each ball club has enjoyed a three-point lead. Bottom of the net for Jeff Gross. Second bucket for Jeff.
That's a pretty shot that he has there. Just goes right straight up.
Didn't take a lot of time to get it away either,
no,
does he?
No, sir.
They got him posted down inside. A lot of black shirts in there. No good on the attempted shot by Paul Hendrickson. Warsaw with it and a chance to go in front as we head toward the end of the first quarter. If they get the bucket here, they'll have their biggest lead of the game. It's now at 3. Nobody's been further ahead than that since the opening tip-off. You see the clock in the bottom of your screen. Gross couldn't get it, but a foul called. Blocking foul against Warsaw, they say.
That's Marty Lehman, I believe.
That's true, and that's number one on him, second against the club, so no shots involved. But Vincennes will get it. Chance to chop that lead to 1 prior to the end of the first quarter.
Number 45, Warsaw, Marty Lehman.
16 seconds remain in the first quarter. Alice's 24-3 on the year. Warsaw 25-2, both with hard-fought victories here at Market Square Arena earlier today. Waggoner missing, tapped up once and good by Randy Hobson, and that's it. Hobson picking up his first points of this ball game, and after one, it's Warsaw 13 and Vincennes 12 for the state championship. One of your network sponsors, American Fletcher National Bank. Market Square Arena, 13-12 your score. Warsaw's got the lead. Steve Hollar has 7 of those 13 points for the Tigers. Tim Swan has 6 for the Alices. Look into the Tiger cheering section, and they are here in force tonight. Heading down from the north, Vincennes coming up from the south. Second quarter of play. Joe, anything stand out in your mind, first period?
The quickness of Vincennes showed up, I think. They got a lot of good shots inside, but missed a considerable number of them. Their defense, Tim Swan is playing right in the middle of the lane. If our viewers are watching the free throw area, number 30, Tim Swan will be back in there looking to help whenever the ball goes inside.
Well, that's a good move to the hoop by Rob Randall's at top for Warsaw. Randall's playing well with only his second bucket, but he is a force. He had 19 points Yes, compared to his 14-1 average in this afternoon's game. The lead goes back to three again. Paul Henriksen. Henriksen's second bucket. Joe, they appear, they being Vincennes, appear to want to force it in like they did this afternoon. They want to go in and challenge the big guys.
Same attack, that's right. They go at the big man trying to get them in foul trouble.
45 seconds is history in the second period. It's a 15-14 lead for Warsaw. Either club has had leads of as high as three, but neither's been able to put the other away with any breathing room at all. Whoa, way out deep in the corner that time, Jeff Gross. Half a dozen points now for Jeff. Joey must like those corner areas. That's where he shot from earlier today.
Jerry, he likes any area.
I think you're right.
He shoots in the dressing room.
I say inside the black lines, it's in my range.
Well, you know, that's what Coach Al Rhodes told me this Monday when they had their meeting. He said, now, if this guy shoots about a 25-footer, I don't want you guys saying on TV, well, I bet the coach didn't want that one. He said, I want it.
Especially if it goes in. Now, there's one at the other end of the floor. This is Randy Hobson.
Gene Miller wanted that one.
It's 17-16. John Osler is keeping our stats over here. We'll try to get a check from John and see how things are going shooting-wise, because they're both putting it up and putting it up with great accuracy. Warsaw throws it away. We haven't seen a great number of turnovers in this ball game, and you might expect it when you're seeing two clubs that have already played one game today, plus playing this aggressively, both offensively and defensively. Rebounded by Warsaw. In the first period, Vincennes hit 6 out of 17. Not all that great. Warsaw hit 6 out of 13 for about 46%. Vincennes right at 35%. Rebound advantage to Vincennes, 10-9. Thank you, John. Couple of minutes gone. Second period. Lehman bounced it down in low, and a whistle and a lane violation, I believe. I mentioned this earlier today. I'll mention it again. You'll see the black band over the left shoulder of the Vincennes players right at the very top. That is a memory of Robert Hill, longtime athletic director of Vincennes High School, who passed away this past summer. James Pittman, who was the principal, is the acting athletic director at Vincennes now. Rebounded by Warsaw, Scott Long, their 6-foot senior starting forward. Up court, let it get away again, and belongs to the Vincennes Alices.
Marty Lehm is without a field goal, without a point in this game, and they're doing quite a job on Marty.
A little surprising, Hilliard, because he is averaging 19.5 per and had 23 in the win. He's the second leading scorer, leading rebounder, and tops in the club in field goal shooting. Tolbert goes to the hoop, offensive foul. Dean with number one. That's just the second against Vincennes in the first quarter.
Let's watch Tolbert here now. He gets a good block. It gets open, but the nice job here by Marty Lehman to get his position. That's the offensive foul.
Joe, let me ask you a question. If you're playing two games in one day, as these young men are, and you have a real good afternoon game, and you come out that night and things don't pick up right where they left off, do you get frustrated? Is that a possibility?
These teams, it's a possibility, Jerry, but these two teams, I really like their confidence. They're playing with a lot of confidence, both of them. I think they have a lot of confidence in what their coaches want them to do, and they're trying to carry it out. I like both ball clubs.
Marty hurt me, Jerry. He came right back and got a basket.
It's a 19-16 lead now with 5:05 to go in the first half, and the lead belongs to Warsaw. Waggoner. Yeah. Charlie Waggoner getting his first two of this game. He's an average of 9 per game, had 10 of the afternoon win over Lake Central. Lake Central young men are all sitting down at the end of the court, all dressed in sports coats, slacks, and ties. Very good-looking group of young men. As are the Newcastle players, for that matter, sitting at the same end on the other side of the aisle. You'll see them perhaps from time to time on the left-hand side of your screen. Nice to see the young men come here and dress in that kind of a fashion. 1-point lead going, reach in foul. He knew it immediately. Lehman missing, trying to pick up the rebound and picked up his second personal foul.
All right, let's watch this second foul now on Marty Lehman. He misses that short shot. He died on it. Didn't go right up and finish up with it, and there's the foul right there, reaching over the back.
Vincennes Alices have 5 returning Letterman. Head coach Gene Miller says, this is the best team I've ever coached. Just taking a ride with them this year, and it's been great fun. He had 5 years at Kankakee Valley, 3rd year at Vincennes. Record of 56-17 at Vincennes. He won 76% of his games. Career record of 140-57 for 71%. Lehman, right side. 19-18 ball game. Warsaw in front. They've got the basketball with 4 minutes to play in the first half. Foul is on Tolbert. on beam number two. There he is, 5'9 senior. It's the 13 foul, so as of yet, no foul shots involved. Warsaw was unranked in both of the polls to begin the year. Final poll by AP had them number 7. UPI put them at number 10. They got the state's longest winning streak now, which has reached 16. Impressive rebound that time by Randles, but it was taken away, just stripped away from him.
Tolbert's out of the lineup now. Jeff Johnson, 22, with the ball.
Johnson played briefly today. Here's a foul prior to the shot. The basket will not count. Joe, mentioning substitutes. As you look at this replay again here.
Here we go. Once again, Jerry, as you talked about, they're knocking the ball right inside. There it is.
You made an interesting point earlier today, Joe, before our telecast, about what effect substitutes may have in this basketball game tonight.
What effect substitutes may have in the game?
Scoring-wise, I'm talking
about.
They're
not going to have much to do with the game, are they, Jerry? Because this afternoon there was 1 point between these two teams as far as their subs.
One point by both teams off the bench. Somehow you would expect more to fall in there, but only one. And I think it was a Johnson that got that, as a matter of fact. Yeah, Jeff Johnson was the only sub for either Vincennes or Warsaw to score today. Henriksen gets two. Paul now with 6 points in the night. And Vincennes goes back in front 20-19 with 3.5 minutes to go in this first half. So that's a good play. They ran that thing off the pick really well, and Gross came around a block on the right side and had a wide open 15-footer.
Right. Rob Randles started on this side, wheeled around to the high post on the opposite side, set up Gross.
Rebounded by Lehman. That's his fifth rebound.
Tim Swan, once again, has cooled off in the second period. He did that this afternoon.
Lehman had 8 rebounds in that victory over Newcastle by 4. In the second game today, there he is again. Shot is short this time by Gross, and a foul underneath the hoop, and it'll be on Vincennes.
By Charlie Waggoner.
Number 2 on Charlie. He and Tolbert each have 2.
Let's watch Charlie Waggoner, number 52, under here now. There's the foul right there. You saw him leaning on his shoulder. Marty Lehman.
Timeout's been called. 2:49 to play in the half. 21-20. Warsaw up for a change. Right now, one of your network sponsors, Farm Bureau Insurance.
The fine coach of Columbus North High School, who did a great job again this year with his basketball team, and he was to be one of our interviewees during this session today, but he had a conflict and could not be with us tonight, and I wanted to let all the Columbus North fans know that we hadn't forgotten him, and he would have liked to have been with us.
He's a good friend of ours, good friend of all of basketball. I bet he was polishing his Hall of Fame trophy. He's a fine man, I'll tell you that.
Sure is.
2:49 to play in the half. 21-20. Warsaw add 2 more to it. They got the turnaround left-handed jump shot by Rob Randles. Lead goes back to 3 again with 2:35 to play in the first half. Swan looking for help.
Swan had a wide open shot. He passed up there. He can't do that.
Here's Hobson.
Yes, he can, and he can give it to Hobson. Let him knock it in.
I guess. Swan had 6 points in the first quarter, Joe, and has not, as of yet, made a mark in the second period column here. 2:05 to play in the half. The lead is 1. Warsaw in front. They got it inside, and a loose ball goes out of bounds. Should be Vincennes. It is. You heard the official on the call. Warsaw has never won a state championship. They were here in 81 and lost to Anderson in the afternoon game, 71-62. Been in the Sweet 16 7 times, Final 8 3 times, Final 4 twice, including this year. They got a rich tradition up there in state championships as far as the girls are concerned. We have a chance to mention that. Here's a walking violation. Warsaw won the girls' state championship in 76, beating Bloomfield 57-52, and then in 78, Jackson Dell fell 75-60. Janice Soyer was the coach up there, is the coach up there. Both ball clubs are 22-0, and they had the Medal Attitude Award winner in 76, and Judy Warren.
Marty Lehman is going to sit down for a few moments, and Joe Sands from Warsaw has got in.
So not many substitutes, as Joe Sexton mentioned, only 1 point out of the subs of both these ball clubs earlier today. So they go to the bench. It's strictly to give somebody a rest and not a whole lot of scoring coming off there. A minute and a half to go in the half.
Okay, Marty Lehman's on the bench. Now, they're going to eat up some time right here. I would guess, if I had to make a wild guess, that maybe Jeff Gross might be the guy that's going to get the shot. He just cleared out of sight for himself.
That's brilliant,
Joe. You're amazing, Coach. You thought about doing this for a living.
I've seen that. I've seen that play before.
Did I mention that he was the Midwestern City Conference Coach of the Year, Hilliard?
Yes.
I don't know if he brought that up or not. Rebound all by himself was Swan, and he couldn't get it to fall. Just inside of a minute and a half.
Maybe Joe'll start getting paid now.
Well, I hope so. Of course, he didn't. The postseason tournament, he didn't do much. But here is Gross again. He was bumped, got it right back, and now he really gets hammered. And the foul's on 22, Jeff Johnson. Number five on him, or number five on the team, rather. Number one on
him. Let's watch this closely now. Here's the pass. Gross might be an offensive foul there. He jumped right in there to, who was that? Hendrickson, right. But then he did get hammered there by Jeff Johnson, as you saw.
Jeff has been the leading scorer in 16 games this year for Warsaw. In football, he was a defensive back as a sophomore. They switched him to a quarterback as a junior. He's one of the top passers in their conference.
His high game, oddly, is 33 points. So Marty Lehman's high game this year is 37.
Jeff Gross, it appears, can do a lot with any kind of ball.
You're right there, Joe. He's one of those young men who's got a tremendous amount of just athletic agility and ability. Now the lead's at five, and that's the biggest lead that either club has enjoyed down to the final 40 seconds and a half. 27-22, Warsaw. Here is Swan.
We have a spread offense here. We don't have a man posted up for Vincennes.
25 seconds to play in the half. There's the time in the bottom of your screen. Five-point lead.
This will take you back to the olden days when they used to play three out and two under.
You'll recall that, but I'll take your word for it, Coach. Final 10 seconds of the half. Here is Swan. He's not had a really great first half. Off it comes to Hobson. Hobson had the shot blocked by... Well, let's see here. The shot was blocked by Sands and a foul. I'm not sure where it came, Joe.
Yeah, on Sands. Sands.
Okay. On Sands, number one on him.
All right, let's watch it here. Hobson had a little trouble getting a handle on the ball. Here's a nice block right there. And then there was the, we got blocked out by the referee, and that was where the foul was. Here's, let's take another look at it. Maybe we have another angle. There's a good block. All right. And there, right there it was. Good. That was a nice job. The other angle showed it. Sands brought his arm down, and it's always going to be a foul when you do that.
Hobson, three-year letterman, three-year starter for all Big 8 Conference this year. Against Floyd Central in that semi-state championship game at Terre Haute, he had 10 out of 14 field goals and 10 out of 10 from the free throw line. What a night. His 7 points so far in this ball game, looking for number eight.
Vincennes hit a basket at the end of the first quarter, two free throws with 1 second to go in this quarter.
And that's it. We've hit the halfway mark of the state championship game. Three-point lead, but still anybody's ballgame. At the midway point, Warsaw 27, Vincennes 24. We'll return to Market Square Arena with some special halftime ceremonies for you in just a moment. First, one of your network sponsors is American Fletcher National Bank.
Warsaw Tigers with 12 points in this basketball game as Warsaw leads Vincennes Lincoln High School by 27-24. Halftime score, Randy Hobson leading Vincennes with 8 points, Paul Hendrickson six. Dean Tolbert sat out a good portion of the first half of the ball game after he got a second foul. The presentation on the court here at halftime, bronze medals to the Lake Central basketball team. Presentation will be made by Robert Strait, principal of Huntington North, assisted by MZ Miller, principal of New Prairie High School. Also the Newcastle basketball team. This presentation by Orvis Birdsall, principal of Alexandria, assisted by Don Noblet, principal at Jasper High School. Let's pick up the ceremony.
Rusty Smith, Sean Alford, Scott Burris, Jason Duff, Rick Pendergraft, Tim Russ. And now to members of the coaching staff, Vance Meyer.
Thank you very much. Great honor.
Larry Meyer.
Thank you. Thank you. Thanks, Jordan.
Head coach, Sam Alford. And Frank Kovaleski, the athletic director.
That's the presentation to Newcastle.
And now Bob Strait.
Sam Alford, the head basketball coach. Frank Kovaleski, athletic director. He has a brilliant football player going to Notre Dame University. Started most of Notre Dame's games as a freshman. And of course, Sam Alford's son, Stevie Alford, with a marvelous freshman year at Indiana University under Bobby Knight. More presentation.
Paul Edwards. Matt Myers. David Ainley. Roger Sulik. John Wallace. Chris Velligan. Mark Saros. Chris Costuros. Larry Gobert. Bogdan Cuckoo. Milan Petrovic. And now to members of the coaching staff, Bernie Kruger, Wayne Sabanoff, Joe Andrews, and head coach Jim Hamill. There they are, ladies and gentlemen, two great teams.
Our congratulations to Newcastle and to Lake Central High School, runners-up in the IHSAA Basketball Championship for 1984. We'll be back at Market Square Arena right after we pause for these messages. Back at Market Square Arena, Indianapolis, I'm joined by the brilliant commissioner of the Indiana High School Athletic Association, Gene Cato. I think enjoying this great tournament, this is its very first as the head commissioner succeeding Ward Brown. And I want to congratulate Gene on just another tremendous turnout in this great throng and marvelous basketball.
Well, thank you. You know, when you have four teams in here like we have today, it makes this job easy and pleasant.
Gene, you have some distinguished guests from throughout the United States. Bernie Sagoff from the state of Iowa, and also Bryce Durbin, who's director, executive director of your national association. And I wish you could have heard the accolades they uttered about this great spectacle.
Well, they have expressed several to me. We're most happy that they are here as our guests, and we think we have a great showcase to show them.
Gene, briefly. The education organization in the state of Indiana is requesting some changes that is going to keep the athletes in school. They won't be able to travel during school hours beginning in 1985. This is kind of a threat to all the ancillary things that go around tournaments and activities.
Well, that is certainly true. We agree with, I think, the same end results that they're after. We feel that high school athletics has always endorsed scholarship. We think we're the only activity that requires that students meet a certain grade standard, and we certainly hope that they can see fit to make some exceptions, because we feel that we're the other half of education.
Well, I'm sure you're going to be working diligently in that area and working hard to make sure that the things come out right for athletics as well as for the classroom, and that's your goal, I'm sure.
That is correct, and I feel sure that we will continue to have an outstanding program.
Thank you, Gene, for joining us again. Congratulations on this marvelous show.
Well, thank you.
Gene Cato, commissioner of the Indiana High School Athletic Association. We'll be back at Market Square Arena with more in just a moment. This message from one of your sponsors, Farm Bureau Insurance.
We are back live at Market Square Arena, and the halftime stats are up, Joe Sexton. Take a look at those.
Yes, sir, and I think that 10 for 27 for Vincennes, they had a lot of good shots, but they missed him. And of course, 12 for 23, just a little over 500 there for Warsaw, 52%. another game where very few free throws are shot, and I think the officials have done a good job. And the free throw shooting that we've had, of course, is 100% there for Warsaw and 80 for the Vincennes Alices.
The individual scoring of that first half, there was not all that much of it for Warsaw. Only four players scored, Joe. It's Gross with a dozen points. See Randles, Hollar, Lehman. A little surprise that Marty only has a couple of points, a field goal in the second period. First half scoring for the Vincennes Alices. A few more numbers in the column. Hobson has the margin there with eight, then Swan and Hendrickson with six. You think Swan's going to get back in this ball game more, Joe?
Swan is going to have to get back in for Vincennes to have a chance to take down the state title. He turned down a shot from about 15 feet in the second quarter, and he certainly can't do that because his teammates have relied on him all season. They won't understand, you know, they won't expect the pass. They'll be heading for the boards. So he can't do that. He's going to have to take his shots.
Dane Tolbert has come back in for Vincennes, the spark plug number 10.
Lehman had five rebounds in the first half to lead Warsaw. Vincennes had six rebounds from Swan, so while he is not shooting well, 3 of 8, he did go to the boards, pick up a half a dozen efforts there. Advantage 16-14 in favor of Warsaw. Now they tap control for the second half by Vincennes. They trail by three. Warsaw led by five. Late in that first half, that was the biggest lead for either club. Swan going to the hole, missed the first one, missed the second one, but will go to the free throw line. And the foul is on number 33. Rob Randles, that'll be three on him.
All right, let's watch Rob Randles foul him on a second shot here. There's the shot, up. Now he gets it again, Swan gets it again, and then there's the foul. Rob Randles brings his arm down.
I notice on that tip, Marty Lehman hardly got up in the air. I wonder if the back is bothering him again.
He's had some problem with that, hasn't he, throughout the year?
Yeah, they are muscle spasms.
Here's Swan. Tim's a 76% shooter. He did not score in the second period. He is now 1 out of 2 from the free throw line and 7 points in the game. Now full court pressure for the Alices. Down by one early in the second half. Great crowd on hand tonight. The folks up in Warsaw made the trip down from the northern tier of the state. Folks in Vincennes made the trip up here, and they have come to enjoy.
We have a change of defensive assignments. Our fans can watch now. As they can see, right there's the ball in Jeff Gross's hands, and Tim Swan is on him now.
Lehman, left side to Randles. Sticks down the lane and got the left-handed scoop shot. Randles with 8 points. Scored 19 this afternoon and played very, very well. Back to a three-point lead again for the Tigers of Warsaw. Lehman on the rebound. Marty is not scoring a great deal, but he is still putting in an effort out there and contributing in other ways. Foul is called on Vincennes. They will tag number 54, Paul Hendrickson, with his first of the night. And the first against the ball club in the second half.
All right, let's watch Rob now. Randles here. Hendrickson's going to foul him. There's a nice pass inside. That's about all Hendrickson can do is throw his hands up in the air. Must have gotten him with the body.
So Rob Randles at the free throw line. He's a young man who made the pass to Marty Lehman to win the basket against Michigan City. Rogers said he didn't know who it was down there. Couldn't see him. All he could see was his feet. He said that Lehman has the biggest feet he's ever seen, so he threw it to the guy. And Lehman gets the hoop. Randles gets the assist. They get the win. They're playing the Final Four.
I think he saw who it was.
You think he did, huh? He has 10 points now. All four of Warsaw's second half points as they go in front by five again.
Five consecutive free throws for Warsaw in this game.
Open man, right side, Hobson. He's hit double figures with 10. Dean Tolbert has not been that much of a factor in this ball game. Joe, is Warsaw doing anything defensively to take that little guard out of this out of the game?
He missed some shots early, to be very honest with you. He was 1 for 3 there in the first half, and he had a couple shots inside. He just hasn't been able to go from inline to inline.
Came out with that rebound. 5'9 senior, 13 and a half average at 15 this afternoon. He has two tonight. Had it taken away by Warsaw.
Good play by Steve Hollar, a junior.
Couple of minutes gone, second half, 31-28. Warsaw with the lead and the basketball.
I don't think Al Rhodes liked that shot.
Now, Lefty better fake that shot, take it to the hoop, and give him the finger roll like he did the time before.
Vincennes crowd begins to rise in unison, trying to get their ball club fired up. Waggoner going to the hoop. He'll be fouled by Warsaw by number 25, Steve Hollar. First of the game on Steve, second of the second half against the Tigers.
All right, let's watch now. Steve Hollar makes his foul. Reaching right in there. It's just an aggressive play, and you don't mind getting a foul like that when a guy's going after the ball and stopping a guy driving to the basket.
A look into the coaching staff across the way of the Warsaw Tigers, indicating defensive and offensive alignments and sets. They've been doing that all day long. Just too noisy to try to yell to your ball club in a din like this with 17,000 plus looking on.
Rick Pryzinski is in the lineup for Vincennes, 34.
Hobson basketball, cross court to Swan. Swan got inside amongst the big guys and got it. For Tim, 10 points. Six in the first, four here in the third period. That chops the lead to one again at 31-30. Almost a steal by Tolbert and deflected away.
That gave me a little evidence of perhaps a little fatigue on the part of Warsaw, because Tim Swan drove that ball all the way from foul line extended to the basket. Nobody picked him up from the opposite side. That Warsaw hasn't allowed that to happen today.
Lehman, 10-footer. Rolls and falls. Only the fourth point from Marty. He's averaging 19.5 per with a 23-point effort against Newcastle today. But his ball club is up by three, 33-30, with 4:50 to play in the third period. They move it inside, and the foul is on Lehman, and that'll be three on Marty.
Okay, they're posted up again now. Let's watch the pass, left-handed pass, and there's Lehman reaching in. Must have had his right arm laying on the...
Randy Hobson will toss it in for the white-shirted Alice's of Vincennes. Tolbert directing traffic. Jump ball. Good defensive play that time by 43, Jeff Gross. When that ball goes in, Joe Lowe, you can just see Warsaw coming from every direction. Watch him surround him here.
Watch the replay. Now, he should throw this ball out. Hendrickson should throw this ball out. It's too crowded. You feel that kind of pressure. Nice play by Jeff Gross tying him up. But Hendrickson should have thrown the ball back out.
Hendrickson got the tip. Vincennes has the basketball again. Here's Tolbert. Swan, Tolbert again. Penetration down the lane. And a whistle and a blocking foul. It'll be on Warsaw. On that young man climbing off the deck down low.
Scott Long.
And on Scott, number two.
Let's see if Scotty Long is set here now. Tolbert's using that quickness that he has. No, he's still moving. Nice call by the official.
It's a fourth team foul against Warsaw in the second half, so Vincennes could get in the shooting situation very quickly in this ball game. Tolbert, first trip to the line tonight. He had a field goal in the first quarter. That's the extent of his scoring to this point of the game. Tolbert, at one point, hit nine in a row field goals we're talking about against Floyd Central in that semi-state championship game. He and Randy Hobson are the co-captains of the Alice's. Points for Dean. Lead is cut to one again. Vincennes can't seem to climb over the hump, though, to get back in front. They led by three in the first quarter, by five in the second. They have trailed, make it three in the first quarter. That was the extent of their sizable leads, and they have trailed by as many as five. A bump and a foul. It'll be on Hobson. He didn't have any idea there was a black shirt around him when he went up for the rebound and smacked into one of the Warsaw players. Watch the rebound come off Long to the left.
Okay, let's watch Hobson on a long rebound now. Right there's the foul. He knocks Steve Hollar right to the floor.
It's the second team foul against Vincennes in the second half. Still a one-point lead for the Tigers, looking for their first ever state championship. And another foul on Hobson, two in a row. He had a span of about 6 or 7 seconds.
All right, let's watch the replay here now. Here's the pass in, trying to knock it inside to Rob Randall. Nice job there. There's the reach-in foul.
Still no shooting violation, not in the bonus as of yet, so Warsaw will inbounds beneath their own hoop. Oh, great play. Good feed inside by Steve Hollar to Marty Lehman. Lehman has a half a dozen points now. And the lead goes back to three again. And just as quickly, it's chopped to one as Hobson hits his 12th point.
Randy Hobson has the hot hand this evening for the Alices.
3.5 minutes to play, third period. Neither ball club able to shake the other by more than 5 points. Vincennes' largest lead at three. Right now it's a 3-1 type ball game. They get down by three, then down by one. Now they're down by three again. Steve Hollar with his 9th point. He had 7 in the first quarter. And it's a 37-33 lead. He is 4 out of 4, is Hollar, from the field. And 1 out of 1 from the free throw line. Great move inside. Good strong effort by 52, Charlie Waggoner. Charlie getting his 2nd bucket, 4th point. Pressure and a violation on the inbounds pass.
Rob Randles hit the baseline.
Timeout. With exactly 3 minutes to play in the third period, Warsaw's got a 1-point lead. Vincennes has the basketball, and we've got a break coming your way. We'll return to Market Square Arena in just 1 minute. Joe Sexton, Butler University head basketball coach, alongside Hilliard Gates, also with us in Fort Wayne. This is Jerry Baker. Joe, it's a 3-1 ball game right now. Vincennes just can't climb over that little hump they got out in front of them there.
Not only they can't climb over the hump, but Warsaw can't get away from either. I think we got a good one going down to the wire here, Jerry.
Inbounded to Tolbert. Sets up at guard. Looks in the middle now to Hendrickson. Goes the other way. Swan. Now Waggoner. And Swan again. Here's Hendrickson. Now they got over the hump. Hendrickson with 8, and Vincennes goes in front for the first time in a long, long time. Alice's lead 38-37 with 2:35 to play in the third period.
Jeff Gross has not scored in the second half for Warsaw.
Lehman has picked up a little bit of that, but not a great deal. He has 4 points in the second half. Gross missing. Rebounded by Warsaw, almost taken away and finally out of bounds to Vincennes. Wild battle that time between Randy Hobson and that young man climbing off the deck where they go out to mop up some of the perspiration, of which there is plenty, Scott Long.
That was a great effort down in the corner for that basketball
by both players. Vincennes' biggest lead of the game was 3 back in the first quarter. They could match that lead now. Swan. Little head fake to the right, goes left, and the rebound comes off to Warsaw. Less than 2 minutes to go, third period, and a technical foul on Vincennes. It'll be on Gene Miller, their head coach, who was upset about something.
He was upset, said that his man got fouled on that shot, Swan.
First technical foul we have had today. Gene, graduate of South Newton High, Wabash College, master's degree out of IU. At the other end, Warsaw gets a free one and a second opportunity. This is Gross, by the way, at the line. Jeff with his 13 points. He's now 3 out of 3. Now 4 out of 4 from the line. Plus, of course, Warsaw will get the basketball at midcourt. There's Dean Miller. His assistants, Roger Benson out of Kentucky Wesleyan, Dennis Curry out of Kentucky Wesleyan, and Kim Proud, a graduate of IU. Al Rhodes with help from Dennis Van Dyne, Pete Smith, Jerry Ryman. A unified effort to get your ball club to the final championship game. Foul blocking Warsaw, tag number 25, Steve Hollar. Number 2 on him.
That's a 15 foul.
So the bonus is in effect. We'll come down to the other end and take the free throw shots now. Head coach of the Warsaw Tigers, Al Rhodes, grad of Penn High School, Tri-State University. Fourth year at Warsaw, record of 65-35, has won 65% of its games, won 3 sectionals, 2 regionals, 2 semi-states. He was the IBCA, the Indiana Basketball Coaches Association, District 2 Coach of the Year this year. Congratulations to Al. Swan can't get it. Now with 1:40 to play in the third period, 1-point lead for Warsaw. Jeff with 16 points, his first field goal in the second half to go with the other two free throws that he picked up, and now he goes back to a three-point lead again at 41-38 with a minute 17 to play. Swan. Yes, sir. Tim with 12. Now, what have we got? Another?
We have a technical
another
foul.
Another technical foul.
Not on the bench. He hit the ball when it was out of bounds.
Take a look at it again. Now, watch what happens here. There's the technical foul right there.
That's
right.
It.
You saw Steve Hollar trying to throw it in, and the defensive man reached in and slapped it away, and there's no question about that call. So we'll send Gross back to the free throw line. With another couple of shots. No, it's a one-shot technical foul. It was not on the bench. So he's picked up 5 points in the period. Three of those have come on technical foul shots. Now we're on even numbers, 42 to 40. With a minute to play in the third period.
24 as Jeff Tucker went in during that free throw for Warsaw.
Got the ball right now, and he walked with it. Tucker's a junior, six-footer. He played very briefly in the afternoon game and did not score. 50 seconds remain in the third quarter. One of those technical fouls eat you up alive, won't they, Coach? Giving up free ones?
Well, it cost them 3 points. Sometimes it inspires your team, but you never know about that.
Dean Tolbert hitting a field goal for the first time since the first quarter. He has 6 points in the game, and we're tied. And believe it or not, that is the first time this game has been tied. Almost a steal at the midcourt stripe. Swan out there hustling with 20 seconds to play in the third quarter.
Marty Lehman is just not moving much around the foul line at all for Warsaw.
Marty's tired. He has his hands on his knees right now. He's very tired.
Here is Gross. Out to Randles. Even 12 points for Rob, 2-point lead. That's the end of the third quarter of play. We've gone through three. 8 more minutes left to decide who's going to be the king of high school basketball at Indiana. It's Warsaw by 2, and we'll return to Market Square Arena for the final chapter in a moment. One of your network sponsors is American Fletcher National Bank. Warsaw Tigers' average win this year was 15.5 points per game. Their average loss, 11.5. Vincennes' average win, 15.6, exactly the same as Warsaw. Their average loss was only 5. They lost 3 games by a total of 15 points. One of those was a one-pointer at Gibson Southern, the other a two-pointer to Broad Ripple here in Indianapolis. And they were also beaten by Terre Haute South by a dozen. Warsaw, loser in the opening game of the year to South Bend LaSalle, 83-75, and then to South Bend Adams in the South Bend tournament, 63-48, so they lost 2 games by a total of 23 points. Final 8 minutes of basketball for the state championship. Tap control by Vincennes, picked up by Tolbert. And a steal. And a foul that saved a hoop by Swan. First on Tim.
Let's watch this. This is a nice steal here. Beauty for a guy 6'7", Marty Lehman. And here's a good save right there. Hit him once, hit him again, catch him. Good job.
Lehman's going to Ohio University, Joe.
He'll go to Ohio University. He's going to redshirt his first year, Jerry. I talked to Al Rhodes about it. They have 4 guys that are going to graduate after next year. And so he's going to redshirt that first year. Wouldn't get to play much, they said. Anyway, he needs to build his body up. Physically, he's pretty weak.
For the uninitiated, that means quite simply he'll go to school, attend classes, but will not play at any games. Can he work out, Joe? Is he eligible to do that?
Yes, he can work out.
So he'll get some valuable experience. This is a learning process. All alone under the hoop. Missed the first one. Got the second one to fall. Paul Hendrickson made a good strong move to the hoop, and the first one came up just off the front edge of the rim. Now he has 10 points in the game, and it's a 45-44 lead once again for Warsaw. into Lehman.
Uh-oh.
And a foul as Marty started to go to the hoop. I thought for a moment he'd been hit with an offensive foul.
I thought, he got hit with a travel, Jerry.
Yeah. Well, that's what G. Miller throwing also. Take a look at it again here.
There's the pass. He brings it back out, and right there's where Swan hit him with his knee.
Talking about Marty Lehman, he had a broken wrist midway in the season. We talked about this earlier today. Played three games, fully properly diagnosed it as a break. Then he missed a couple of games. And you tell me, Hillier, that during that span of time, he played very well.
That's right. He missed three games after the fracture was diagnosed. But he played three after the injury.
High ball game of 37 this year against Huntington North at 23 in the afternoon win. He has 9 points in this game. Only three field goals. 3-point lead again for Warsaw. It's been that kind of a game right from the get-go. Up by three, then up by one, then up by three again. Good position on the rebound by Rob Randles. Wow, Warsaw can inch that lead a little bit further with just a little less than 7 minutes to go in this ball game. Scott Long and Dean Tolbert. Here's Randles again. Taken away by Tolbert on a good defensive play. No advantage on the break. Lets the traffic catch up. 6.5 minutes to play in this ball game. Here is Swan. On the near side, rebounded and knocked away beautifully by Lehman on the attempted shot by Paul Hendrickson. Lehman really skied that time. Swan makes the steal, but unfortunately for the Vincennes Alice's fans, stepped on the out-of-bounds marker.
Very quick ball game tonight.
They're getting their second win. You get the feeling like that they're ready to go for the final 6-16 of this ball game.
It's the second time down in Florida, Jerry, that they get their hands on a pass. Warsaw's going to have to be a little sharper with their passing.
Walking. Randall.
I've been watching Jeff Gross, and he's not involved in the offense much right now either. He must be very tired.
I believe Warsaw's more tired than Vincennes.
I think the whole darn arena's tired. 6:09 to play in the ball game. It's 47-44 Warsaw over Vincennes. Timeout. One of your network sponsors is Farm Bureau Insurance. We invite you to stay with us after the telecast of the action here at Market Square Wiener tonight. We'll have the Trester Award winner, presentation of the runner-up, and championship trophies. And Hillier will have some time, I would assume, to chat with some of the players and the coaches.
I might have time to come back and chat with you a while.
In fact, the way it's going, yes. Bring a friend. A couple of minutes gone in the fourth period.
First all-night telecast of a basketball game.
Vincennes with the basketball, trailing by 3 points. Hendrickson couldn't hang on. Saved, though, by Vincennes. Tolbert's got it. And a whistle. And a foul on Warsaw. And they're looking in the direction of Scott Long. Number three on Scott. Second here in the second half against him.
Here's a nice pass inside now to Hendrickson, and there's the foul. Scott Long reaching in.
Hendrickson missed four games this year with a broken hand, showing no effects of that now in the regional final against Evansville Bossy. He had 20 points and 9 rebounds, so he can explode. He had 12 points in the victory earlier today over Lake Central, and now with that free throw, he has 11. He can match his 12-point afternoon total right here.
He's an 82% free thrower, and he has a pretty good form, Joe. Never fails.
Okay. 11 now for Paul. 2-point margin. Vincennes got the lead briefly in the third period. Trailed at the end of three, 44-42. Now it's 47-45. Warsaw. Tigers are really, show to give them credit, they're meeting the challenge very well because Vincennes must have made 20 runs at him in this ball game here.
Yes, sir.
Almost a steal by Swan, but very quickly out of the pack was Gross, who takes the shot and hits it. 19 for Jeff. Averaging 21-7, top score on this Tigers ball club. And the lead jumps back to 4 again. Tolbert got bumped, but he walked.
Jeff Gross for a moment thought he was going to be called for a foul when he saw the travel signal. He burst into a kind of a cheer and a wide laugh.
Seven turnovers against Vincennes in this ball game and a foul. Seven on Tolbert. It's Tolbert's seventh turnover of the ball himself.
Fouls on Swan. I think it's his fourth. Check it, third.
Seven turnover for Tolbert.
Yep.
They had seven as a team for this afternoon's game. Seven as a team, which I thought they were outstanding with their passing this afternoon.
Got 10 as a team so far tonight. Now, when you got a guy handling the ball as much as he does, you're going to have a few more in your column, I suppose. Well, Jeff Gross, that's his 20th point. He's been perfect from the free throw line. 6 out of 6. 81% free throw shooter. Leads the club in that department. In the fourth period, 5 out of 6 from the line for Warsaw. They pick the lead up to a half a dozen. 51-45, and that is the biggest lead that Warsaw's had in this game. Waggoner to the hoop. Waggoner is fouled. Is it Lehman, I believe?
Yes, it's Marty Lehman with his fourth foul. That's right. Let's watch it here now. There goes the drive by Waggoner, and there's the reach in by Marty Lehman. It's his fourth foul. He's going to come out, take a little rest.
What? He will go out. 31, Joe Sands, a 6'1 junior, comes in. Waggoner goes to the line. Waggoner, of course, as we have mentioned throughout the day, is only a sophomore. He started some of the games last year as a freshman.
Waggoner's only a 50% free thrower.
A violation of the lane that time against number 13, Scott Long, who jumped in too quickly. Al Rhodes looking on across the way, encouraging his Warsaw Tigers. What that means is just forget about that free throw, and Charlie Waggoner will try it again.
That's a big play. They had a chance to get the ball with a 6-point lead, and now it could be four. Charlie got a little reprieve there, didn't he? Charlie's been a little quiet this evening. I thought he was tremendous this afternoon, but he's been a little quiet on the boards.
He had 10 points and 5 rebounds, hitting 3 out of 9 from the field and 4 out of 8 from the free throw line in the afternoon game. 4 minutes, 45 seconds away from the final gun at Market Square Arena. Still anybody's ballgame, although Warsaw has fended off a number of challenges by Vincennes. They lead by 4, 51-47. White shirts everywhere on the outside shot by Gross, and here come the Alices again. Here's Tolbert.
There's that quickness, Jerry, getting all the way to the hoop again.
He has 8 points. And it's a 2-point game, 51-49.
Now both teams have played so hard, and whoever makes a spurt here now is going to win this basketball game in the state championship.
Halfway through the fourth quarter, Joe, it's time to reach down and pull out everything that's still in you, right?
And there's no tomorrow, like you said.
Foul on Charlie Waggoner.
Away from the ball. Third one on Charlie. Of course, you're in the bonus now for both ball clubs, so free throw shooting becomes a significant factor. Vincennes is a 69% shooter on the year from the line. They hit 65% today. Warsaw on the year, 66, but they hit 94% from the free throw line of the afternoon game against Newcastle, hitting 16 out of 17. Joe Sands, 3.7 average. Can't get it. And the rebound comes off to Henriksen. Vincennes could tie the ball game for only the second time. And a foul on Warsaw. And it indicates that Rob Randles has picked up his fourth.
Here comes that quickness again now with Tolbert. And Randles going to move over there and get him with the body. Stuck his left leg out there.
So Dean Tolbert goes to the free throw line. The All Big 8 conferences here is the young man that hit those two critical free throws with 1 second to go to beat Evansville Bossy in the regional final. He's an outstanding tennis player, too, guys. Number one singles player on the Alice's tennis team.
Well, if he makes this one, it'll be 6 points in a row then for Vincennes to tie this ball game.
It was tied once at 42. Nobody had a tie. Neither team tied in the first half. But each had a lead, 3 by Vincennes and 5 by Warsaw. And we got a tie ball game again. tied at 51. With 3 minutes and 40 seconds to play for the state championship, both cheering sections are on their collective feet. Second ever by Rob Randles. On the missed shot by Gross, Randles missed the first one, stayed right with it and got it home, and it's a two-point bulge now for Warsaw, 53-51. Here is Swan. Inside they go to Hendrickson. He missed it, and the rebound comes off to Warsaw. With exactly 3 minutes to play. Is it slowdown time yet, Coach?
Yes, it is. I just saw them raise the Iowa sign over on the bench in Warsaw, and that's where they have their two men on each side of the foul lane, as we can see.
Now the guards become oh so critical. Steve Hollar is 25. 13 is Scott Long, all by himself inside, and almost a great play by Swan, but instead he'll pick up the personal foul, and that is his fourth.
Well, let's watch. Steve Hollar gets a nice pass in there. He's all by himself as they were two-timing out on the floor. Here's Tim Swan swatting that ball away and getting the foul. Now, this is the same thing they did with their Iowa setup this afternoon, got the uncontested layup.
Steve Hollar at the free throw line, number 25, a 6'1 junior. 4 out of 4 in the first game today, 1 out of 1, now 1 out of 2. Is a 72% free throw shooter. He has 9 points. 7 of those came in the first quarter. He is the third Warsaw player to hit double figures. Only 4 players have scored for Warsaw. Rebounded by Randles with 2:25 to play and a 3-point lead again. Well, that is so typical of the way this game has gone. He's got the ball to Hollar. Still set up in that Iowa defense, or Iowa offense. Scrambled on the floor. We'll probably get a jump ball out of this. And look out. Bodies begin to fly all over the place. And one of the Vincennes players, Tolbert, is down on his knees on the other side of the timeline to the left of your screen. And he appears to have caught a finger in the eye. There he is. That is Tolbert. Mad scramble for that basketball. And that's really kind of typifies the kind of a day we've had. Give no quarter and ask no quarter.
It's a mad scramble for the state championships, what it is, Jerry.
That's exactly what it is. Watch this to begin to develop here.
See, the problem with holding the ball for Warsaw is the quickness of Vincennes. They are so quick. Watch this. Here's where it happens, right here.
He got going kicked in the it. Side of the head, didn't he, Joe? Yeah.
Looked like he did, didn't he, Hugger?
Mm-hmm. On the right side of the head. He's sitting up now. He looks like he's going to be all right.
The officials, I'll tell you what they're doing, Joe, right now. They've got an injured player, Tolbert. Really what I think they're letting him do is just sort of cool down a little bit.
Let's watch here.
Difficult to tell, either a knee or a foot or something caught Tolbert. He's not going to leave the game, I don't think. Well, he'll have to leave the game.
Either they'll have to take a timeout, yeah, or he'll have to leave the game.
Until the next dead ball.
That's right.
So he will go out, and they'll send Jeff Johnson in to replace him. But I will guarantee at the next dead ball, he'll be back.
Yeah, I don't know how many timeouts Coach Miller has, but I think if we get the ball, I'd take one. Get him back in there. He's all right.
I think he's got one timeout left, Joe. 2 minutes and 6 seconds to play, 54-51. Warsaw, they have led at every quarter stop. And Vincennes gets the ball with the 2 minutes precisely showing on the clock.
A nice steal there by Swan.
Tolbert's already going back down to the scorer's bench. Oh, good baseline move by Hendrickson. And Paul has 13. 1:43 to play. Boy, that could be an eternity if you're the team with the lead. 1:38 to play in this contest. Now 1:35.
We have the quickness of Vincennes now. Against this holding the basketball by Warsaw. We'll see what happens.
Jeff Johnson committed the personal foul, Joe. Then he goes out of the ballgame, and as you suggested, Tolbert is right back in there again. There's Tolbert. No worse for the wear. Scott Long, who has not scored in this ball game. He had 10 points and 7 assists. He's the leading assist man of the ball club. He's done that tonight. And that's his first point of the game.
He's only a 61% free thrower on the season, however.
Vincennes is hitting 2 out of 9 from the field here in the fourth period. Only 2 for 9.
They've shot poorly the entire game, Jerry.
Down by 3 with a basketball and a minute 25 to play. The Alice is looking for their third ever state championship. Warsaw wants number 1.
Warsaw's in a zone defense right now.
Well, there's a strong move with the hoop by Charlie Waggoner, too. Waggoner with 8 points, 4 of them coming here in this fourth and final period. Good pressure being employed by Vincennes. They knock the ball away. Vincennes has got it, and a foul on Warsaw. Oh, my.
There's Jeff that quickness, Gross. Jerry.
Jeff Gross with his first personal foul at a critical time for it to come. Take a look at this baby again.
Watch this scramble right here. There's Jeff Gross with the ball. There's the steal by Hobson. Foul on Gross.
And Hobson, who has but 4 points in the second half, 12 of the night, is at the line where he is 2 out of 2 and a 77% shooter. But first off, a timeout. With 1:05 to play in this contest, Warsaw 56-55, but Vincennes is going to the free throw line as we go for a break. One of your network sponsors is Farm Bureau Insurance. Wayne Ader is the superintendent at Vincennes. James Pittman, the principal and acting athletic director. Enrollment of about 1,047, four-year school. Larry Crabb, the superintendent at Warsaw. Richard Klein, the principal. Dave Fulkerson, the athletic director. Enrollment of slightly over 1,200 in a three-year enrollment up there. Al Rhodes and Gene Miller are the coaches. They've done an outstanding job. The fans have enjoyed the ball game, and they have really been here in mass today. Here is a big free throw by Randy Hobson. He's got the roll. The 6'1 senior, who had 13 points and 5 boards in the afternoon game, has picked up his 13th point in the championship game. Vincennes can take the lead for only the second time in the second half. He short-armed it, and out comes the Warsaw Tigers with a minute to play. Boy, you couldn't want it any better than this, could you? Here is Gross. Swan did a good defensive job on him. Gross shoots over him and misses. And the rebound comes off to Paul Hendrickson of Vincennes. And will jump it up. Another mad scramble for that basketball.
I was about to say, wouldn't Warsaw play for one shot? But apparently not.
Watch this. There's the shot by Gross. The rebound here is by Hendrickson. Now somebody's going to reach in here and get the ball. Hollar got the ball. And then there's the scramble. We have a jump ball. And this is the biggest jump ball for these kids.
Certainly of the entire year, perhaps. Tie ball game. The tip is controlled by Warsaw. They kick it back out to the point guard. 13, Scott Long. Long going against Tolbert. Down to the final 37 seconds and a reach-in foul on Tolbert. And on Dean, that's number 3. And I'm not so sure it's all that bad a foul, Joe.
We'll find out, won't we?
Well, we will, won't we? Sure beats waiting until the final 3 seconds to commit a foul like that.
I agree with you. And when you're as fast as Tolbert, you have a chance to strip the guy and not make the foul. But if you get a foul, they still have 36 seconds here. Plenty of time for them. A lot of pressure on the free throw shooter here.
Scott Long, president of the student council, knocks the first one home. He is 3 out of 3 from the line. His only 3 points of this game, and they've all come here in the fourth period. Comes off of the near side to Randy Hobson. Here we go, folks. Hang on. 30 seconds to play for the state title. 1 point lead by Warsaw. Vincennes basketball. Swan tries to grab a look at the scoreboard here at Market Square Arena. Now to Tolbert. Down to 19 seconds to go. We are inside 15 seconds. Tolbert's got it. They're looking in the middle. Now we're down to 10. Tolbert one-on-one. Baseline shot is up, and it is no good. The shot is missed by Hendrickson, and a foul of the rebound is against Vincennes. With 3 seconds remaining.
Here's a replay. There's the shot by Hendrickson. A nice soft shot. Off the rim, there's the rebound. And the foul. Here's the foul. Let's look at it again. Dives right in there. And you have to do it with 3 seconds. If you don't make the basket, you have to foul the rebounder. Foul. Two-shot foul. That is intentional.
All right. Here is Steve Hollar. He is 2 out of 3 on the night. 10 points. Now with 3 seconds to go.
Here it is.
If Steve can nail this baby, then Warsaw is going to hang a championship banner in that gymnasium of theirs. He's got it. This ball game is history.
Oh.
It's all over. The Tigers of Warsaw High School, in a sensationally played, hard-fought battle right to the wire, defeat the Vincennes Onassis by a score of 59-56. Nothing quite like winning, is there, Joe?
Well, I've played in this game, and I was on the other end of it, so I can tell you that's a pretty bad experience, although after a little while you realize how much fun and how your ball club, what they had done throughout the year, so you're happy with your ball club and with
it's
the experience
an honor,
that you had.
It's trite, but it's true. It's an honor just to participate in a championship game like this.
That's right.
Joe is a member of the Tech Titan Ball Club in Indianapolis here a few years back. Won the Trester Award. That'll be presented here tonight also. I've lost complete track of Hilliard, so I'll tell you what we'll do. We'll take our break, then come back and try to ferret things out. Final again is 59-56 Warsaw over Vincennes. They're the state champs, and we'll return to Market Square Arena in a minute. One of your network sponsors is American Fletcher National Bank. Hilliard Gates is at courtside right now with the winning coach. Hilliard?
Well, Al Rhodes, we're going to get the ceremony started, but this is absolute bedlam out here. Congratulations, Warsaw, first state basketball champion.
Thank you, Hilliard. We're very proud. We've got a lot of young men that have worked very hard to achieve this. Proud, very proud of each and every one of them.
Your team was tired.
Extremely tired. Vincennes was too, but neither team let up. They played a great basketball game, and they certainly have nothing to be ashamed of. You know, all four teams today, I think, are champions.
You told me early in the season you were a good foul shooting team. You certainly did that again here today.
Well, then we said hit some big ones. Scott Long and Steve Hollar did the job again.
Was there any point at which you had this game wrapped up?
Well, the situation went, not really, until they missed the shot there at the very end, and Steve hit the free throw.
Al, you've been working so hard after the trip down to Indianapolis in 81. I knew you had an ambition to get back here, and you did it in 3 years.
Well, we're very proud of that. After the final 14 before, we were 4-18. Marty Lehman and Jeff Gross were on that ball club, and you see how far they've come in 3 years.
I know you want to get with your team, get the awards. We'll be back to you a little bit later.
Thank you very much, Elliot.
It's been a marvelous coaching performance. All right, let's go to the ceremony.
By the way, Al Rhodes, the hot salt water will help that sore throat which you're going to have for the next couple of days. They're going to ask now for the Vincennes Onassis to climb the platform here at Market Square Arena, and they will receive their runner-up awards. And let's go over to the PA system and pick up the announcements right now.
Charlie Waggoner. Paul Hendrickson. And then assistant coaches and administrators, Paul Hendrickson, the last player. Congratulations to the players. And out of the coaches, Kim Prout, Dennis Query, Roger Benson, Gene Miller, and Jim Pittman. You'll have the welcome, ladies and gentlemen, the state runners-up for 1984, a tremendous team from Vincennes Lincoln, home of three previous state champions. And they deserve an outstanding salute to a fine state finalist team.
The school song of the Vincennes Odysseus. They were state champs in 1923, won it all in 81. Gunnar Wyman took them all the way to the finals and won it, beating Anderson 54-52. This is their third trip to the championship game.
Now presenting the runner-up trophy.
Now let's go back to Tom Carnegie again.
Shorty Birdsall.
Here comes the runner-up trophy.
And incidentally, Shorty Birdsall on the board of the IHSAA is a graduate of Vincennes High School. Okay. Now at Alexandria High School, incidentally.
Alices are to be commended on a sensational year, finishing up 24-4. And I guess, Joe, all four of the final teams are pretty well summed up by Al Rhodes. They have nothing to hang their heads about, nor do any of the final four teams have fought their way to this level of competition.
Well, their shooting guys just left them tonight. Yep. They just couldn't hit.
In fact, I don't know, John, do you have with you what was the shooting story as far as Vincennes was concerned? Well, ask John Osler to figure that up for us. 21 out of 49, so that's about 43%. And all the year, Vincennes had shot 51%. How about Warsaw? We got them. They were 20 of 40, so right at 50%, and all the year they shot 53%.
John White will present the medals. John White, rather, of the board.
Here we go!
Will present the medals.
Here we go!
Let's line up the champions now.
Now the championship medals. To the Tigers of Warsaw.
Scott Long. Greg Marsh. Bob Randles. Tracy Furnival. Jeff Gross. Mike Hall. Steve Hollar. Robert Johnson. Joe Sands. Jeff Tucker. Mike Norris. There's your team of 12. And the head coach, Al Rhodes, in his second try.
So the individual honors for the Warsaw Tigers. Now comes that championship trophy.
Pete Smith. Athletic director, Dave Fulkerson. And principal, Richard Klein. There you have them, the state champions.
It wasn't an easy road for Warsaw. They beat Wawa Sea and Triton in the Triton sectional, Penn and Plymouth in the Elkhart regional, and Fort Wayne Elmhurst and number one Michigan City Rogers in the Fort Wayne semi-state. Here comes the presentation of the trophy.
A board member, N.Z. Miller.
Here it is. that, we'll be back. We got the Tressler Award winner coming up. Return to Market Square Wyndham. Let's pause now for these messages. Have the state's longest winning streak up to 17. They become the third Elkhart regional winner to reach the finals in the last 4 years, and the first, of course, to win it. And the celebrating continues here at Center Court. And let's go now back over and pick up the Prester Award announcement.
At each of the 17 state tournaments sponsored by the IHSAA, a mental attitude award is presented. To qualify for this Tressler Award, the recipient must be in grade 12, be nominated by his principal and his coach, excel in mental attitude, athletic ability, scholarship, and leadership during the 4 years of high school, and participated in the state finalist in the IHSAA state tournament. At this time, we would also like for the parents of the recipient to come down with him. The winner is Milan Petrovic.
Milan Petrovic of Lake Central, the 1984 recipient of the Arthur L. Tressler Award. Presentation made by Robert Strait of Huntington North, chairman of the IHSAA Executive Committee. Milan Petrovic. Fine ball player, Joe, and obviously an outstanding student at Lake Central High School.
You know, I had a chance to, before the game, he was sitting down there with his ball club, and he said, I had a chance to talk to him a little bit, Jerry, and he said, I really feel good, he said, about our team, and he said, we really had enjoyed a year, and we have a lot to be proud of, and so he showed a lot of maturity, and he's a very happy young man right now. He's obviously an outstanding young man in all areas.
He's an honor student who plans to study engineering in college, ranks 20th in the class of 485, a member of the National Honor Society. There's Milan on your screen. Hilliard Gates will join him momentarily, and we'll get an interview with Milan Petrovic. He's a member of the Key Club, delegate to Hoosier Boys State last year. All right, before we get a chance to chat with Milan as the pictures are taken and the celebrating continues, we'll return to Market Square Arena in a moment. Score again was 59-56. The winner, Warsaw over Vincennes for the state title. One of your network sponsors is Farm Bureau Insurance. Basketball Network at Market Square Arena. The celebrating continues for the Warsaw Tigers, a 59-56 winner over the Alices of Vincennes. Up on the platform at Center Court at Market Square Arena, Milan Petrovic, who has just been awarded the Tressler Award. Hilliard Gates is also out there with him.
Thank you very much, Jerry. And here is the 1984 Tressler Award winner. I talked to you yesterday. I went back to the hotel and called for Wayne and told everybody what an outstanding young man you were then. I think you're even greater today. Congratulations, Milan.
Thank you, sir. It's a great honor, and I feel privileged to get in.
Well, I know you'd rather be the state champions, but if you can't be that, winning the Tressler Award's got to be a coveted, marvelous feeling inside.
I can't describe the way I feel. It's named after such a prestigious gentleman, and to receive it, you know, it fills me with joy.
Milan, I understand you're a 3.9 student, is that correct?
Yes.
And you'll be playing college basketball for Rich Falk at Northwestern?
Right, right.
What are you majoring in high school?
In high school?
Yeah.
I'm working towards a career in engineering at Northwestern.
What is your ambition then after college?
Oh, I don't know, just to hopefully get a good job and raise the family.
What are your hobbies? What do you do when you're not playing basketball? Study.
Girls.
Oh, very nice hobby. Do you have a special girl?
No.
You play the field. You play the field.
Yeah.
May I talk to your mother?
Sure.
Your mother? What is your name?
Helen.
Helen?
Petrovich.
Helen, get over here so everybody around the great state in the Middle West can see you. Tell me about your feelings at this moment, and tell me about the great studying of Milan. I know that he was not born in this country. He was born in Yugoslavia, is that correct?
No, he was born in England.
He was born in England?
In England, yes. He came over here when he was 4 years old.
I see.
Yes, and it's hard to describe how I feel. I just feel great, and I'm one of the proudest mother in the world to have a son like Milan.
Well, he is an outstanding young man. He communicates well. He's a handsome young man, and he's also a heck of a basketball player.
Thank you.
Well, congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Let's talk to Jim Hamill here, the coach of Lake Central. Jim, the camera's right here. Your feelings at this moment?
Harry, you know, I told you during the week how proud we are of him and how proud we are of our whole basketball team. But Milan's been the, you know, the guiding light for us since he's the one that stood up there in the top row last year at this time and said we could be here. And, you know, nobody ever deserved a trust award more than he reminds me so much of Mike Weaver. You remember Mike?
Oh, absolutely. And Mike to North.
Right? Right. Mike's going to North, went to Northwestern, you remember? And Mike talked to him tonight before the game. He's a great kid. He's a great kid, and we're happy for him.
Has the hours since this afternoon softened the feeling inside the stomach?
Well, it hurts. You know, we just don't feel like we played as well as we had. So it hurts, but our kids played hard, and that's all you can do.
I think you'll be back.
Well, we hope so.
It was great working with you this week. Good luck to you, Jim.
Thank you, Harry.
Thank you very, very much. Jim Hamill, the coach of Lake Central, who guided this great young man to the Truster Award here in basketball this year. Let's go back to Jerry Why. I'll get some more interviews here. Jerry?
All right, Hilliard, thank you. Here's the individuals going. First off, for the victorious Warsaw Tigers, they had five players scoring, three of those in double figures, 21 by Jeff Gross, 14 by Rob Randles, 12 points out of Steve Hollar, 9 more from Marty Lehman, and final 3 points from Scott Long. Your thoughts on the offensive attack at Warsaw? And remember, Joe, we said that Jeff Gross wasn't really playing the kind of game we thought he was going to play, but he still finishes up with 21 points, and he had 22 this afternoon.
Well, he's 7 for 19. That's the thing, Jerry. And the real difference from this afternoon to tonight is Marty Lehman, who we felt was pretty tired, very tired, as a matter of fact. He ended up with only 9 points, but he did get 8 rebounds, Jerry. So
those are the team numbers, by the way. Excuse me, Joe, on the screen, those are the team shooting percentages, what have you. Warsaw, 50% and 43%. Anything? Well, rebounds, 34 to 23. There's one of the big statistics right there.
Yeah, there's 11 rebounds, and that's what you said prior to the start of the game. They were about a 12 rebound per game above them, but the 43% is what got Vincennes, I think.
All right, briefly, Vincennes scoring 13 points apiece for Randy Hobson and Paul Hendrickson, 12 points out of Tim Swan, and 10 points out of Dean Tolbert, and the other 8 points belong to Charlie Waggoner. Final again is 59-56. We'll return to Market Square Arena in just a moment. One of your network sponsors is American Fletcher National Bank. Back out at the center court area at Market Square Arena, Hilliard Gates has the athletic director at Warsaw High School, Dave Fulkerson.
Well, and you're looking at the medal that Marty Lehman is wearing. Dave, congratulations.
Thank you very much, Hilliard. It's a great thrill to make it to the Final Four, and it's even a bigger thrill to win it.
Well, you told me when I was over there a week ago Wednesday with Chris Schenkel and some of the other great people from the Warsaw area that you might have a chance at winning this.
We felt the big thing was, and I mentioned in the semi-state about the kids being unselfish and our guards getting the job done and getting it to our big people, and they did it at the semi-state, and they did it here tonight.
Dave, do you have a celebration planned for tomorrow at Warsaw?
Right. We want the whole town of Warsaw to be at the Warsaw Tiger Den at 4 o'clock. The team's going to be coming in on the fire engine, and we're ready to go.
Okay. Congratulations, Dave. I know it's a great, great thrill for you.
I just put on you one of our Tiger paws, so I expect you to be a Tiger fan for the rest of your life.
Well, I've been very close to that fine community, and I enjoyed all my associations up there.
Thank you very
much, David. Let's talk to Marty. Marty, you know, you told you last week how quick you were, how well you play. You play in great tempo, great poise, but this was a very tough game tonight.
Yes, it was. It's hard for me to come into one game and then win that one and play another game the same day. I really sweat a lot.
I know when you put your hands on your knees alongside of the foul circle along about the middle of the third quarter, you were tired.
Yeah, I was tired about the first quarter when we started running up and down the court.
What about the back injury? I saw them treating you here with ice packs. You didn't practice yesterday morning at all.
Well, it was the muscle strain that I got Thursday during practice, and it'd been bothering me quite a bit, especially on trying to shoot the ball. But we had a couple doctors work on me and give me massages and loosen up the muscles as much as possible, and that seemed to do the trick.
Did it bother you at all tonight?
Very little.
You're an articulate young man. At what stage of the season did you have visions of possibly getting down here and winning this thing?
Well, after my injury, after
you fractured your wrist?
After I broke my wrist, and we had other guys come in to take my place, and that made our bench that much deeper when I came back, and we just started winning games, and our team play started getting really good, and everybody was getting unselfish, and then we started having our dinners together during the tournament, and that just brought us together like a family.
Well, savor it, young man. It's a great thing in the state of Indiana. Congratulations.
Thank you.
You're going to Ohio University. I know you're going to redshirt for a year.
Yes.
Best wishes to you.
Thank you.
Okay, let's talk to Jeff Gross. Here's a young man, only a junior. What tremendous talent he has, and he will expand that talent as a senior next year. Jeff, congratulations.
Thanks a lot. I'm really happy we could win the state today, and, you know, it's just a great feeling to be down here.